Honestly, all right, you guys, so I've already started to sew down my frontal right now, as you see. I've just went ahead and added some T-pins so that way that the hair won't fall off. So I'm just taking my needle and my thread, and I just use some regular hair threading. I want to say the hair threading thread. Say that five times fast. Hair threading thread, hair threading thread, hair thread. Oh, forget it. So I just went ahead and I placed it on top of my needle. And of course, all I'm doing right now, as you can see, is just sewing this down onto my wig cap. Now, the wig cap that I use, pro choice, is the netted wig cap. Now, a lot of people like to use the dome wig cap. I really don't like using those because I really don't feel like my hair breathes. And I enjoy using these netted caps because I am able to allow my hair to breathe underneath the hair that is sitting on top of it. So that's a major plus for me. And on top of that, they stretch very well. So if you guys were looking for a great cap to apply your wigs on, this is a really, really, really good one. Now, I would not continuously keep doing the hot glue method on this cap only because I just feel like it doesn't stay as long, but that's just my personal opinion. I would do the hot glue method on a regular dome cap, but today we're doing the hot glue method on this cap. And she did work pretty decent, but I did have to reapply the glue later on. I want to say like a few weeks later, but that's besides the point. So after we went ahead and just sewed this down, I'm just gonna snap off the excess thread and let's go ahead and use these bundles. Now, I just went ahead and went into my old drawer and just found some bundles that I had for God knows how long. And obviously, there are two different types of bundles. So I'm just going to be using just a regular glue gun with these glue sticks. Now, I got my glue gun from Walmart, and I do believe that I paid $8 for it, but that's because it also came with the glue sticks included. So we're just going to start from right here. I'm not going to bring it all the way down there. So I'm going to start lining up my bundles going around this way. So I like to use my T-pin to kind of give me a guide. Most people do, most people don't. It's totally up to you. But I'm going to also do the flip over method so I can preserve as much as my bundles as I can because I feel like I might end up using these bundles again for another day. So we're just going to go ahead and start applying the hot glue onto the cap and then apply the track. Now, as you see, I'm doing right now, I applied the hot glue to the track, and I kind of didn't really like doing that after a while. You'll see me switch it up over time. And so I actually started just doing that one for, I do believe that that was just the first bundle that I end up doing that on. And then after a while, as you see, I just put it right on top of the cap and keep it moving. Now, this process is very, very quick. If you guys want a wig done in an hour and a half or less than an hour, this is the best rate to go. Doing the hot glue method or doing the regular hair glue method. I don't like using hair glue because it's a little harder for me to clean off of the bundle when I'm finished using it or when I want to deconstruct the wig and reinstruct another wig. Because I like to recycle hair. I don't know about you, but boo-boo, my coins, I am really frugal with my coins when it comes to my hair. I don't know why. It's so weird. I am not that frugal when it comes to my food, though. I wish food was on top of my head because God knows I'll spend a coin or two. But I don't mind spending a coin if it's for the quality. Don't get me wrong. But she likes to preserve her bundles. So as you see, I'm just layering this thing on down as much as I wanted. I did maybe like two fingers apart in order for me to just lay these the right way because I didn't want my hair to be too full because my natural hair is not that full. I wanted this wig to mimic my natural hair. I didn't want her to be too long because my hair is not that long. And I didn't want her to be too thick because my hair is not that thick. And I really don't know how to manage thick hair. I don't mean no harm. So we just gonna keep it realistic as a mug. AF, AF. So as you see, I am just layering this thing on piece by piece. I am applying this hot glue. As soon as I apply the hot glue, I am quickly laying this track because if you don't, honey, it would be a total mess. And that is not the type of situation you want to deal with. Trust and believe, she is super annoying. Now, as you see, some of the glue kind of just started to fade off, such as looking like I call it like spider webs in a sense, but don't worry about that. It comes right off. It doesn't attach to your hair, so you don't have to worry about it sticking into your hair and you being like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? you ain't gotta worry about that. So we're gonna go ahead and move on to the second bundle. I actually only used two bundles in this hair for this wig, which was a bomb plus on top of that, because I didn't really feel like using bundles after bundles. I actually have four bundles to use, but I wanted to see if I could make a wig with two and make it still look decent enough, and it worked, obviously. So I had a 14 inch as well as a 16 inch, and my frontal is a 12 inch. I meant to tell you guys that right in the beginning. I will place another video for you guys to see how I bleached my bundle with, excuse me, my frontal, not my bundles, but how I bleached my frontal. You guys, I had to bleach this thing twice. And if you guys are not okay with bleaching your frontal twice, I will teach you a way to actually get away with doing it and it's still looking natural AF. So as you see, I am just now with the second bundle, as you see, I am actually placing these tracks a little closer together than I did with my first bundle, only because as it gets closer to the top, it gets more visual and visible, rather, not visual, but visible. And I don't want nobody saying, girl, you got some gaps up in there. And I'm like, girl, don't play. Mm-mm, I ain't got no gaps. She decent. So as you see, I just went ahead and did a close up, and I'm continuously doing the U method and flip over as much as I can and as tight as I can on towards the top of the frontal. Now, as I get towards the front part, and I actually, my camera actually died, I started to cut off certain pieces of the track to fill in closer towards the front part of my frontal. Well, the back part of the frontal and towards where the back of the hair is considered the front part, from the back of the head to the front. So I just went ahead and started cutting pieces to kind of more so shape that part, because I couldn't really keep doing the flip over method right here, and it was kind of sucking, but it was okay. I didn't have to cut off too much of the bundle, so I was able to preserve as much hair as you see right there. Now, wig is completely done. Let's go ahead and prep this hair. So I'm using some alcohol on this. Woo, good gracious. I'm using some alcohol on this cotton pad, and I'm just going to wipe off any excess oils or moisturizer that I had on my face, so that way that when I apply my glue or whatever, she can be able to stick. Sticking this wig cap on my head, I got it in a neutral color. I should have gotten it in a brown color, but that's besides the point. So I'm just going to be taking my Eco Styling Gel, because I love this stuff and it works so well for my edges. I don't mean no harm. I really don't really use too much edge control on my natural edges, because she don't really be doing too much. Not unless I use my She Is Bomb edge control, but I didn't use it this time. So I'm just going ahead and make sure that my edges are laid underneath this wig cap. I don't know why I put the wig cap on my head, because for obvious reasons. Then I had to just sit her on the neck, because she just wanted to fly away. Ain't nobody got time for them flyaways. So I'm just going to make sure that my hair is brushed back, so that way that this wig cap can slick back, slick, clack, clack. Yeet. I don't even know what that means. But I'm going to be taking the Got To Be Glue. Now, the only reason why I'm using Got To Be Glued is because I'm not wearing this wig for no more than a day. Okay. I always highly suggest using Got To Be Glued if you're only using your hair, putting your wig on for just a day or maybe a day or two. If you want to leave your wig on for a week and some change, I would totally recommend you using Ghost Bond Glue or Bold Hold or one of those Maximum Hold lace glues. That way that your lace front can stay as long as you wanted to. So I'm just going to be taking the back of my eyebrow razor, and I'm just going to be applying this glue to the edge portion of where I want my lace to lay. Now, I didn't know how far I wanted to allow this to lay. Now, there are different ways that you can actually measure it, so you won't have to worry about having too much glue on your head, but I'm rushing at this moment. I really didn't have time for that. So I just applied the glue to where I think she gonna go, and then I'll just wipe off the excess. And you can wipe off the excess glue with alcohol, which you will see me do in just a few minutes. So I just wanna make sure that this glue is evenly spread out across my head, so that way that I know that I have enough glue. Now, I did two layers of this, just to let you know, so that way that I know it's going to be secured. And I mean, I'm trying to secure this wig, okay? Secure that bag, secure that wig. So I'm just gonna be taking my blow dryer, and I'm putting this to the coolest setting. Okay, you need to use cool air to dry this glue. Do not, and I repeat, do not, not use hot air, okay? Because your feelings gonna be hurt. Now, as you see, I constructed these two little bands on the back of this wig, so that way that it can sit and stay, because I don't like using combs. at all, because I don't like my hair feeling like it's being pulled and dragged, and oh, it's so annoying. Combs are super annoying in a wig to me when it comes to making my wigs. Now, if it's already come with pre-combs, that's cool and all, but when it comes to my wig, I'm not with it, like for real, for real. So I'm just gonna be taking this wig, and as my glue has already dried, I'm just gonna be taking piece by piece, and I'm taking a rat tail comb, so that way that I won't really try to touch it with my fingers, but I accidentally touch it with my fingers. That's where you see it, where it's white right now. And that's a situation that you don't wanna have to really deal with, because it takes a little bit longer to clean up. Yes, I'm gonna clean it up. As you see, she just looks, ooh, good night. That's just nasty looking, but it's all right. Once again, we're gonna make it work. So I'm just making sure that this is planted onto my hair and onto the glue, not on my hair, I'm sorry, my hairline where the glue was sitting. And I'm just making sure that my rat tail comb pretty much touches it by the grace of its hands, and making sure that she is laying and sticking like nobody. Sticky, okay? Sticky baby, ooh, ooh. So I'm just laying this portion by portion. I'm kind of just, I want to say massaging this onto my hairline. Sorry, you guys, I'm kind of still coming over a cold, but she's all well and dandy. But I'm just using my blow dryer to, on cool setting again, to make sure that my lace is sticking to the glue. And I'm just going over and over my head right now with the rat tail comb, making sure that, oh, good gracious, y'all see that? You see how nasty that got? Don't worry, we're gonna clean her up. She's not gonna look that nasty, but I just want you to see how the lace is laying down. She laid down pretty decent for the most part. And you guys, you wanna know what's so funny? This is actually the first time I'm ever laying down a lace frontal. How about that? She did that on the low. So I'm just using some, oh God. Hurry up and get her. Cause I don't want that to go into my eye, cause that would be a tragedy situation and that is not cool. So I'm just taking a Q-tip and I'm just gonna be making sure that I take off this excess glue, because it is super sticky and nobody got time for that. That Q-tip wasn't really doing too much for me, so I went ahead and used this cotton swab, and I'm mad that I used it because she got attached to the glue and on top of the lace. That is so annoying. Super uber annoying. And that Q-tip just wasn't doing nothing. So I just went ahead and just used my fingers. And don't worry, we did go back into the Q-tip with mad alcohol after a while, and let's clean her up. You see how clean that is now? Like, just clean her up. Alcohol does wonders. Alcohol, as well as after you apply the alcohol, you should definitely apply some oil just to get rid of all the excess whiteness that you would probably see from the got to be glue, because got to be glue sometimes can be so disrespectful and so racist. Like, I know I'm black, but I ain't trying to wear my frontal look like it's white. So I'm just like submerging the crap out of this Q-tip with some alcohol and making sure that I get all around my edges, even when I'm turning red like a red bone. I mean, you better soak that baby. I went through everything just to try to get this nasty gook off of my head and off my face. Also, because once I apply my foundation and my makeup, I don't want to have the excess glue sticking to my head. Like, that's just ugly looking. So I'm just taking some regular Bonner Brothers foam, setting foam rather, and I'm just gonna go ahead and lay these edges. Now, I don't like real baby hair. I like my edges to look like it's naturally edges. So as you see, the way that I'm actually get ready to do this is not your traditional baby hair method. I just want to make sure that this hair is laid naturally, and that's how I like my hair to look, and like frontals to look very, very natural. I'm not really big on too much baby hair. As you see, this is just the most that I'm pretty much going to do, to be honest with you. It was a struggle, I'm not gonna lie. I had to actually cut some baby hairs out, as you can see. Well, I keep saying baby hairs, but cut some of my edges out to make it look more realistic. So I just took a little bit and razor cut it with my eyebrow razor and just went ahead and constructed it just the way that I really wanted it to. I still had a little bit of got to be glued on my hairline, so it kind of helped in a sense, so that way that it can lay the way that I kind of wanted it to lay without me having to apply any more free spray to anything else on my edges. So this is pretty much me playing around with this. Once I applied and laid my scarf on top of it, it kind of laid on its own, to be honest with you. So I'm just pulling this down, but as you see, it's not completely dry. So I had to add a little bit more free spray to this and just add some more cool air so it can dry quickly. I know a lot of people that will allow it to sit first before they start laying their edges, but me, I'm just so ass backwards sometimes. So that's pretty much the tea on that. So that's pretty much it, you guys. Once I applied this and I did this, I allowed my scarf to sit. Oh, I forgot. I did blow dry my hair one more time to make sure that she is secured. And after I did that, you're just going to lay a scarf or a wrap strip to set your wig to your head. And I did that for about 20 minutes. And then after I took my scarf and that wig thing off, I applied some powder foundation and some contour powder. Well, I just used my contour powder rather. And I just went over the edges of my hairline to make it match my skin tone. And I love the results, you guys. This is my first time laying a frontal. And I think she looks completely natural. And I am completely pleased with how she turned out. She ain't moving. She's stuck. You see how I'm pulling her? She ain't going nowhere. Look at God. Look at God. Won't she do it? Slay, baby. Slay all day. Thank you guys so much for watching. And remember, God is love, so love, love. Bye. I'm gonna do it just later.